Welcome to RA Medical Hall for today's men's basketball game, featuring the visiting Webster University Gorlocks and your Amherst College Blue Jays.
Yeah!
Before we begin today's game, we ask at this time that you all please rise and face the flag as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Time for game two of a doubleheader, Elmhurst and Webster. Men's basketball action here on Blue Jay TV. Glad to have you alongside Tim Calderwood with you today. Elmhurst has dropped the first five games of the season, including three of those here at home. Earlier this week, Elmhurst fell to Westminster College on Wednesday. Westminster is also out of the St. Louis Intercollegiate Athletic Conference, the same conference in which Webster makes its home. Webster had a two-game win streak snapped on Wednesday, falling 72-49 to Wash U, who was in the top 10 nationally. The Gorlocks are 4-3 overall. It's the first ever meeting between these two programs in men's basketball here today. Starting five for Elmhurst, Deontay Foster, Alex Morganov, Taylor Baxter, Nick Sanford, Michael Yurkovich. It's Alex Morganov in the center circle. We're underway. Elmhurst with the basketball as he wins the tip. Elmhurst in the home whites, traveling right to left here in the opening 20 minutes of play. Baxter pops out, looking to lob for Morganov, trying to score down low. Over-pursued a little bit, but was able to recover as he actually dribbled past the double team, and Elmhurst strikes in the first possession of the day. Starting five for Webster, Cody Bradfish, Hollis Edwards, Roman Robinson, Danny Zahner, and Aaron Griffin. A scoop attempt by Roman Robinson is no good. Second chance for Aaron Griffin, swatted by Morganov, and possession will stay with Webster. Inbounder is Hollis Edwards. Backing up is Edwards. Elmhurst opening in the man. A drive and Robinson converts. Roman Robinson averaging 13.1 points per ball game. Webster has four players averaging in double figures, so they can come at you from many different directions. A carry is called on Foster, first turnover of the day. Chest high dribble for Bradford as he works. Leaving for Robinson, looking to lob underneath. Entry pass, Morganov tried to front Aaron Griffin, but Griffin, who averages just under double figures, able to score for Webster. Losses for Elmhurst this year. They've been competitive in just about every ball game. Sanford scores underneath to tie it up. Lost by one at home to Dubuque, lost by four at home to Concordia, Wisconsin. Also lost by four at home to Westminster. Lost by eight at Albion, and lost by 12 at Carleton to open the year. Should be a backcourt violation, it is. CCIW so far very strong. Elmhurst is the lone winless program. Augustana knocking on the doorstep of the top 25, 6-0. North Central in the top five nationally, 6-0. Wheaton in the top 25 this week at 7-0. Illinois Wesleyan nationally ranked as well, 5-2. And now an over and back against Elmhurst. And Mark Shear is quickly on his feet. On the Elmhurst bench, the longtime Blue Jay headman. North Park is 4-3. Carthage 4-4. Millikan 3-4. And then Elmhurst winless in the CCIW. Plenty of other action today. Trine at North Park. Millikan taking on Mid-Continent. Augustana's at Wisconsin-Stevens Point. Simpson at North Central. Wash U at Wheaton, that's a big one tonight. Hollis Edwards is shaken up. Edwards whistled for the offensive foul. And he'll depart with Dietrich Suter entering. Suter, a senior out of St. Louis, Missouri. Majority of the roster for Webster coming from Missouri, head coach Chris Bunch. However, there's a scattering of players from other locations as well. One from Michigan, one from Colorado, one from Mississippi, one from Tennessee. In addition to three from Illinois. Baxter from beyond the free throw line converts. Six-four Elmhurst on top. On the move is Robinson, score it and a foul. First Elmhurst foul. Michael Yurkovich whistled. One shot coming here for Robinson. And he converts. Webster as a team from the line this year, 66%. A little trapping defense for the Gorlocks, nearly forcing a turnover. Floor vision from Baxter, who transferred in from Loras this year. Also has some time at Division I North Dakota State. And Sanford held up as he attempted to drive along the baseline. Fouls on Aaron Griffin. His first team foul number two. Deontay Foster backs up, and a three-quarter court receives the feed. Foster wide open, long three, money from 23. 9-7 Elmhurst. Suter on the point. Feeds the cutting Bradfish, and it's knocked away. Webster averaging just under 81 points per ball game this year. Compare that number to Elmhurst, which is under 65 a game, and you have to figure the Blue Jays need to find a way to keep this a low-scoring affair to have an opportunity at victory number one here this afternoon. Shot clock at 15. Zahner in the corner. Now it's Suter into the corner again. Bradfish for three, and the lead. Webster, pretty good three-point shooting team at 36%. Bradfish, nearly 50% from the land of three this year, and that on 21 attempts. Comes up with his first 3 points. Taylor Baxter on the move. Baseline left, long from 16. Jurkovic, offensive rebound. Sanford, attempt number three, no good. And away comes Bradfish. Quick outlet in the vicinity of Zahner. Dribbling out of control to Bradfish for three. And the rebound belongs to Morganov, who will quickly outlet as well, and Elmhurst needs to slow the tempo down. Foster trying for a three of his own, and the lead no good. Zahner in the rebound. Cradles the basketball as Webster continues to lead by a point with 4.5 gone in the first. On the dribble, Suter pulls up and hits, creating for himself. Sanford outside the lane, air ball. And here comes Webster again. Zahner travel. Substitutions for the Blue Jays. Three warm bodies entering. Kenny Payonk, Kyle Wiest, Bryant Ackerman. Webster switching to his own, daring Elmhurst to beat him from the outside. Baxter will try. Three-pointer. Yes, sir. Tying the score at 12 apiece. Second three for Elmhurst. Foster and now Baxter have converted here in the first 5-plus minutes of the half. And Robinson with a nice drive. One thing I'll say about Webster, players so far are doing a good job of creating shots for themselves. Not much in terms of the ball movement, just good spin moves, trying to draw the defense in. Shot clock at 20 for Elmhurst. Around the arc we go. Ackerman lost the basketball, able to tap to Baxter. Three again, no. Sanford swats at the rebound, and his second a chance tips away into the arms of Aaron Griffin. 13:55 first half. It's 14-12 lead for Webster. Stepping out is Bradfish, retreating. Now it's knocked away from Robinson, and last touch by Webster. Turnover. Ahmad Smith, Jared Husky enter for Webster. Elmhurst looking to tie or take the lead. Here's a three-pointer from Wiest, short. Again, Sanford swats at the rebound. Ackerman, a third attempt. And Elmhurst has to start finding a way to make some buckets. Guess it's strong effort on the glass so far for the Blue Jays, but they need to turn those second-chance opportunities into points. Here's Smith into the lane to the left side. Bradfish for three. It's a five-point edge for Webster. Sanford between the rings, lobbing underneath. No on the attempt from Paya. Now it's Robinson all the way. 19-12, Mark Shear with his arms crossed on the Elmhurst bench. Taylor Baxter dribbles to the corner and takes a timeout. No signal of yet, whether it's a full or a 30, and now the decision has come from Mark Shear. It's a full timeout. 12-27 to play in the first half. Webster with the lead at 19-12 on Blue Jay TV. Tim Calderwood from R.A. Faginal Hall, where it's Webster 19 and Elmhurst 12 here on Blue Jay TV. Early look at the numbers reveals Webster is shooting 80%, 8 of 10 from the floor, including 2 of 3 from bonus distance. Elmhurst, meanwhile, just 5 of 14, despite a commanding edge on the glass. Foster looking to lob. It's Wiest on the move, dribbling out of control. Now Foster along the baseline, pulls up and connects. Second bucket for Deontay Foster, who came in during the timeout to replace Taylor Baxter. Baxter on the bench with a game-high 5 for Elmhurst, who's within 5 at 19-14. Ahmad Smith to the corner, tosses one off the glass. Smith is the leading scorer for Webster off the bench, averaging almost 15 points per ball game. Smith, the first time this season, is not starting as he's in a reserve role today. Had been a starter all year previously. Elmer's continuing to work, and an offensive foul is called. Nick Sanford. And Sanford will exit. Eric Dornfield entering. Eleventh 25 to play first half. A lot of basketball. Smith to the corner. Rotates it around, and a three-pointer is down for Brad Fish. The third on four attempts for Webster here in the opening half. 22-14, 8-point lead is the largest of the game so far for Webster. Dribbling in, pulling up. Bryant Ackerman connects. Ackerman, a freshman, hailing from Indiana. Touch under 5 points per ball game. Nice dump off towards Husky, who missed his wide open hook. Dornfeld down Main Street is fouled from behind by Husky. And Eric Dornfeld, a senior from Geneseo, step into the line. Dornfeld at 6'7". First free throw good. Returning for Webster, Aaron Griffin. Dornfeld at it again and good. 22-18. with Webster with 10:27 to play in the half. Traveling, Griffin tried to hesitate. It's another turnover here with 10:22 to play, first half. Weiss rolls right, outsteps Foster, three-pointer, good! 22-21. Good response by the Blue Jays here in the first half as we reach the midway point. Suter's three is no good, a quick shot perhaps. Mayong grips away the board. Sets a screen for Foster, circling right. Dornfeld. Foster is open again, top of the key, yes sir! Elmhurst in front from down nine to up two. Nice recovery for the Blue Jays and a hold away from the basketball. Kyle Wiest with the foul, his first. Alex Morganov is off the bench. Hollis Edwards, inbounds. 9:23 in the first. Elmhurst by a pair. Shot clock down to 20. Robinson walks. Slight hesitation trying to get his defender to bite. Forgot to take the basketball with him. Morganov calling for the ball in the paint. Draws a crowd, flips it out towards Weiss. And a timeout, Webster. Well, Webster has gone into his own defense, and Elmhurst may shoot Webster out of the zone. 27-22, the Blue Jays in front. A timeout on the floor. Elmhurst, 5 of 8 from three-point range. With 8:47 to play, the tide has turned. This is Blue Jay TV. Left of the first. Elmhurst was down 9. The Blue Jays are presently up 5. The shots after a slow start for Elmhurst trying the inside game have been falling from distance. Blue Jays trying to shoot Webster out of his zone defense here in the first half. Turnover. Weiss with the steal. Weiss a no-look feed to Foster. And Deontay Foster on his way to the strike. Foster, the senior out of Muskegon, Michigan, headed to the line. Three-year letter winner. Basically has been starter at the guard position the last 2 years. And his first free throw is good. He started 11 games as a freshman. Out of Muskegon Catholic High School. He already has a dozen for the Blue Jays in the first half here today. And now 13. This lineup has been gelling for the Blue Jays on the floor. Strong comeback for Elmhurst here in the first. 8:20 remaining, another Webster turnover. That is the eighth turnover for Webster, and a lot of those have come simply from mistakes or unforced turnovers. Five bounce pass towards Morganov, who's held up. Aaron Griffin with his second foul. Griffin to the bench. Jared Husky quick to replace him. Morganov off of the lob, has it taken away. Hollis Edwards off to the races. Late foul.
3 feet, got up.
And two shots coming. Second foul on Kyle Wiest. Two shots for Edwards. Nashville, Tennessee product.
Hold on a minute, dude. We're not ready. That's a nice bounce. You got a little pop in your step.
Missed the free throw. Season high 14 points. November 24th. A very close home win for Webster. And the second toss is good. 29-23, Elmhurst by six. Taylor Baxter returns. Baxter, Foster, Ackerman, Morganov, Dornfeld, the five for the Blue Jays. Baxter with a no-look touch pass. Nearly threw it away. Hollis Edwards reaching in. Webster still in the zone, but a little bit more of a matchup zone here. Baxter tries to float one home. And on the weak side, Bradfish comes away. Strutting across half court. An illegal screen underneath the bucket. That's a point of emphasis for the officials. They've been calling it a lot lately. Second on Jared Husky. Team foul number six. So the Blue Jays will be at the free throw line the rest of the first half. Left in the game. Baxter picks up his dribble. Foster starts to move, rolls right around the screen. Playing catch with the newly entered Charles Glass. Foster back near the scorer's table, resets with the shot clock at 13. Taylor Baxter back to Glass, looking to lob, knocked out of bounds with seven to work with. Bounder is Charles Glass. Foster shovels to Baxter, stepping in. Long J is an air ball. Foul over the back on the rebound. Kenny Payon with his first foul. Fifth against the Blue Jays, 6:43 to play first half. 6-point Elmhurst lead, 29-23. Bradfish to the corner. Jump stop, strong move from Robinson, and two shots coming.
You sit when you pee.
Roman Robinson, a native of California. Two shots for Robinson, first one is through. 17 points on two occasions for Robinson this year. Double figures in six of the seven games. Makes good on the pair. It's a four-point game. And a little bit of a trap look for Webster. Foster lost the ball. It's on the ground. Diving on top off of Elmhurst to Webster. So that trap, which Webster really has not had an opportunity to set up much in the first half, leads to a quick turnover. Danny Zahner dribbling off his foot. Baxter the beneficiary. Sips it over to Foster far side. Foster trying to call out the play. Foster stepping in.
Oh my God.
Shot clock at 10. And Morganov throws it away into the Elmhurst bench.
Somebody shoot!
Nick Sanford enters for Elmhurst. Right behind him, Kyle Weist. Robinson as it knocked away. Sanford ahead to Baxter. Baxter off the glass and scores. In transition for Elmhurst, 31-25.
Oh, watch your hands, 22.
Oh. Robinson, isolated baseline, left offensive foul. Over the top of Payonk. Risky maneuver for Payonk with a foul already. Foul on Roman Robinson, who's in double figures for Webster here in the first half. 6-point Elmhurst lead, just over 5 minutes to play. Weist for three. Back iron. Rebound loose. Taylor Baxter will ease it up. Mark Shear calling for a timeout. It's a 30. We'll keep it here during the stoppage with 4:45 left. Webster shooting 64% from the floor here in the opening 20 minutes of play, but down six on the board. Elmhurst shooting 50%. The Blue Jays have hit five threes compared to three for Webster. 11 first half turnovers for Webster as well. 13 points for Deontay Foster. 4:45 left in the first. Elmhurst up six. 27 seconds on the shot clock here. Kyle Weist crisscrossing. Glass surveying the zone. Glass backing up and a walk. 4:31 to play. And an elbow is called against Weist. It's his third. Free throw is good from Cody Bradfish. Double digits for Bradfish in the first half. Second is there as well. 31-27, that's as close as Webster has been in quite some time here in the first half. The They show the three-quarter court trap. Elmhurst breaks it easily. Wiest too strong, and Sanford is fouled on the rebound attempt. Danny Zahner with his first, and Nick Sanford will shoot. Just a one-and-one situation for the Blue Jays. Sanford under 50% this season from the line. Does average 13 points and almost 8 rebounds per game for Elmhurst. And he converts on the free throw. Sanford is the leading scorer for Elmhurst. Sanford and Taylor Baxter in double figures. Alex Morganov just outside of double figures as Morganov returns. 4:11 to play in the first. Sanford ready again, and back iron. Rebound belongs to Jared Husky. And a hand check is called. Nick Sanford commits his second. Fouls beginning to accumulate here in the half. Lawrence Williams in for the first time. St. Louis native. Danny Zahner shooting free throws. And Morganov makes it one and done. Two-two-one look on the trap for Webster. Ackerman threw it off the belly of Williams, but Baxter alertly on the scene to help out. And now falling to the floor is Ackerman, and a whistle. He's likely headed to the line. Danny Zahner commits his second. Dietrich Suter enters.
Good ball, Tim.
Brian Ackerman shooting.
One in the bonus.
No good on the free throw. Williams cradles the board. 3:37 to play. 5-point Elmhurst lead in the first half. Sanford the steal. Stepping in front of the target. Sanford off to the races, to the basket, and scores. 34-27. Brad Fish. Around Morganov, floats one home. Teams have been trading buckets here late in the first. Foster and Ackerman playing catch. Here's Foster. Bouncing baseline towards Sanford, falling away. Shot clock at 10. Foster backing up. Foster on the take. Shy of the elbow has it blocked. Sanford underneath, and he'll head to the line. With 2:36 to play, that is the 10th foul against Webster. Two shots the rest of the half. And it's the third on Danny Zahner.
Sanford, two shots.
Sanford shooting two for Elmhurst. His first free throw is through. Junior out of Decatur, Illinois. Started all 25 games last year. Played in 11 games as a freshman before missing the end of the year with an injury.
Come on, Tim, you're looking a little tired out there, buddy.
Now we have a 7-point game, 36-29. 2.5 to play in the first. Ahmad Smith working on Foster. Smith into the Elmhurst bench. Long 3-pointer coming. a whistle. Will they score the basket? That's the question here. Long three-pointer was good from Suter. And now the officials will quickly talk about what to do. Triangle of officials gathering. Looks like they will score the three as both coaches come to the scorer's table for an explanation as well. Yes, it's 36-32 after the three. Lawrence Williams with the foul. And since it was not in the act of shooting, Nick Sanford is headed to the stripe for two more. Seven first half points for Sanford. Three-year letter winner at St. Teresa High School in Decatur.
Here we go.
Yes, sir. Herald in review, Macon County Player of the Year as a senior. First team all-conference honors as a junior and a senior as well. Also played baseball and football. Sanford at 6'5". And the second free throw is no good. Off of Elmhurst, Ackerman dove on in and knocked it out of the grasps of Roman Robinson. Pressure from Elmhurst. Webster is in trouble and turns it over.
Tim, you're going to call that travel, buddy.
37-32 with 2:03 to play. Scored and a foul. Nick Sanford. Roman Robinson's second foul. For an 8-point lead. Long but nice rebound. Punched out by Dornfeld. 39-32, less than 2 minutes. Baxter is open for three. Air ball. Sanford, though, chases down. Now it's Foster looking for the three, drawing a crowd. Flipping to Dornfeld. Count it plus one. Dornfeld to the line. Free throw money. 10-point Elmhurst advantage, 42-32. And a timeout for Webster, a 30-second timeout. Wheels coming off for the Gorlocks here in the closing moments. You're alongside game two of a doubleheader between Elmhurst and Webster. Closing moments of the first half. Fish having some problems. Brad Fish to the corner, working and waiting. Ahmad Smith, free throw line extended, and he's contacted. First foul on Ackerman, ninth against the Blue Jays. But it was in the act of a shot, so it's two tosses for Ahmad Smith. Free throw is good. Elmhurst makes it look easy. Dornfeld, though, denied from behind. The block from Taylor Walton. Closing in on 1 minute to play in the half. Smith waits for the defense and locates the open Williams, who will score. Turnover. And Baxter with a swat. Dornfeld to Sanford, and one. Third foul charge to Lawrence Williams. Towel comes out to mop up a spot on the floor. One shot for Sanford. Big half, 12 points. Make it 13. .45-36. Elmhurst by nine. Three-pointer coming, no good. Diedrich Suter with a try, shot clock is off. Will Elmhurst hold for the final shot? Certainly looks like it. Taylor Baxter, crossing over. Webster has come out of the zone and into a man. Dornfeld down Main Street, off the glass, too strong. Sanford with a putback at the buzzer. Nick Sanford with the putback, scores it at the buzzer, and Elmhurst is up double digits in search of win number one of the year. 47-36 is our score headed to the break. We'll have statistics and more for you in a little while. I'm Blue Jay TV. We'll be right back. first half numbers. Elmhurst 48% from the floor, 16 of 33, 5 of 10 from three-point range, 10 of 14 at the line. Webster 63% from the floor, 12 of 19. Some very good first half numbers for Webster, and yet they're down 11. A second chance bucket is the way we open the second half with Aaron Griffin scoring for Webster. Webster led by 8 in the first half, Elmhurst by 11. There's a turnover and a steal. Roman Robinson coast to coast. And a frustrating start for the Blue Jays here in the second. Quickly 4 unanswered points in a 7-point game. And again, Webster will apply some pressure. They were trapping in the first half. Also played a majority of zone defense, but are playing man here in the second. And just basically full court man rather than full court press. Here's Ackerman burying a 3-pointer to start. Ackerman receiving some playing time to begin the second half. Place of Michael Yurkovich. Leading scorer for Elmhurst, Nick Sanford, 15 first half points and 7 rebounds. Deontay Foster with 13. Sanford with a steal. He's fouled as well. Corey Bradfish, 13 for Webster. Roman Robinson, 11. Really was a 3-point shooting clinic in the first half. Total of 9 3-pointers each way. Ten-point game, just over a minute into the second half. Foster between the rings, struts right. Targets Morganov, his pass knocked back to Morganov. Foster spotting up in the corner, dribbles around his man. Long J, but Nick Sanford with the follow. Patience for Webster, the name of the game here in the second half. In the line, Griffin converts. Ackerman, patience. Morganov picks up his dribble. Shot clock inside of 10. Morganov cuts to the rack and scores. And a response from Cody Bradfish. Morganov with a flush! 56-44 and a solid response for the Blue Jays after the quick points from Webster here turned it into a 7-point game at the start of the half. And a hold is called underneath. 12 points, by the way, is now the largest lead for Elmhurst today. First team foul, second on Ackerman. In the lane, Aaron Griffin has it knocked away. Foster elevates. Foster spinning away, has it knocked free, and is able to recover. Driving baseline, Ackerman flips it over to Wiest in the corner. Three-pointer good. Yeah. And a response for Brad Fish, long two. Weist, high right, into the lane. Clears it out to Ackerman. Clearing his defender. Ackerman spotting up from Morganov. A response as well. How about the shooting for the Blue Jays today? My goodness. Robinson left it short, but an alert effort by Griffin kept it alive momentarily. Foster leads the break to Ackerman, who was fouled, and a lot of frustration from Hollis Edwards. At the free throw line, Bryant Ackerman, shoe shots with 14:54 to play in the half. Looking ahead for the Blue Jays. This is the middle of a three-game home stint. They'll welcome Lawrence University out of the Midwest Conference later this week on Wednesday at 7 o'clock. And then on Saturday, travel down to St. Louis to meet Wash U, top 10 program, before opening another three-game homestand with Benedictine and then the Blue Jay Classic. Ackerman hits both. And the Blue Jays are really flexing some muscles today. Taking out a lot of frustration from the first five games of the year. Applying some pressure as well. Webster able to break the press. Top of the rack, Edwards for three is good. Foster with a ball above his head. Zinging around into the vicinity of Charles Glass. Glass lost it. Foster able to recover. And I think the officials saw the shot clock reset and are going to hold up play here and discuss about where it needs to be located. Was there clear possession established?
Come on, man!
And apparently so. Weist picks up the dribble. Eric Dornfeld back to the bucket. Three-pointer from the corner. Weist no good. Aaron Griffin with the board. And a hand check is called on Weist. That's his fourth. Taylor Baxter returns. Elmhurst now in a zone. And Webster tried to exploit, but Darryl Lee missed the bunny. And a three-pointer. Timeout Elmhurst, it's a full one with the Blue Jays leading by 18, 67-49 and 12:58 remaining in the ball game. We'll step aside on Blue Jay TV. Timeout for Elmhurst, leading by 18 with 12:58 to play in the ball game. The Blue Jays looking for win number one of the season. Glad you're alongside on Blue Jay TV. Tim Calderwood with you. Don't forget, you can chat along with us if you desire. On the right side of your screen, type in your thoughts. I know producer director Glenn is busy screening things as well. The entire crew is glad to have you alongside here today as Elmhurst forces yet another turnover. These games are available for you on demand at any time through the live stream page and also on YouTube. Baxter shovels to Sanford, jump stop in the lane, spins around, and there to clean it up with a putback is Morganov. Seventeen remaining in a 20-point Elmhurst lead. And a reach around called on Charles Glass.
Personal foul, charge to Charles Glass. 2 seconds.
Jordan Rowland is in for Webster. Chris Bunch is looking for anything to work right now. Three-pointer from Ahmad Smith, no good. Baxter, free throw line extended. It's a 22-point game. Webster already 2 wins in conference play this year, taking down Blackburn and Greenville. As Ahmad Smith will drive and score. Took down Asbury College of Kentucky in Louisville, Kentucky in overtime. Asbury is an NAIA program. A lot of NAIA is actually on the schedule for Webster as I look at it. Out of bounds, it stays with Elmhurst. Deontay Foster, Eric Dornfeld return. And yet another three. Oh my goodness.
You got that right?
73-51. Elmhurst with the edge. And the jumper from Smith in the lane follows it up. 73-53, Elmhurst the edge. Dornfeld shoveling towards Ackerman, bounces into the post. Sanford short, falling out of bounds. Aaron Griffin able to dribble through trouble. Hand check is called as Robinson attempts to drive. K. Three from the right corner. Jordan Rowland. Baxter twisting away to the free throw line. Off to the left, but there's Sanford again. Sanford with 19 points and 10 rebounds for Elmhurst. Leads 75-56. And a floater off target from Ahmad Smith, but a putback is good. Aaron Griffin with a response. Past the midway point of the second, Taylor Baxter taking his time, bringing it up the floor. Baxter starts to move, pulls up outside the lane, no good. Dornfeld punches at the rebound and it went over the backboard. Kenny Payonk for Elmhurst returning, along with Kyle East and his four fouls. Underneath, Jordan Rowland, 75-60, and Webster showing no signs of going away. Foster high into the left, out pops Wiest. Ackerman in the corner for three. And a hold is called off the spin move from Roman Robinson with 8:22 to play. Fourth foul on Ackerman now. Timeout. Webster forced to spend one here as Roland could not inbound the basketball. 30-second timeout. We'll keep it here during the stoppage. Quick look at the numbers for the ball game. Elmhurst 10 of 16 from three-point range, shooting 55% overall. I think if you would tell Mark Shearer that Webster would shoot 66% from the floor and yet Elmhurst would be winning by 18 points, he would have told you you're crazy. Webster 23 of 35 from the field. Elmhurst 28 of 51, 55%. Big difference, of course, the 10 three-pointers for Elmhurst compared to 6 for Webster. Both teams are over 60% from three-point range. Webster's problem has been turnovers. 17 in the ballgame total, 14 of those came in the first half, leading directly to 22 Elmhurst points. Taylor Walton twists it around the arc in the vicinity of Roland. Now Robinson back around the other way. Roland, head fake, into the corner. Long two short, Foster secures. Inside of 8 minutes left. Foster, bouncing in the lane for Morganov, no good. Alex Morganov, the junior transfer from Sacramento, California. Morganov converts, 76% free throw shooter this year. another transfer that has come in. That's kind of been part of the plan of attack the last couple of seasons. Mark Shear has been adding more and more transfers to his roster. Alex Morganov out of the College of Lake County. First team All-Conference last year, second team All-Conference in his first season there. Second toss is no good. Rebound is at the feet of Walton. Foster went for the steal. Robinson breaks it. It runs into the wall of the 6'9" Morganov. Hook shot in the lane from Husky scores. 7:25 remaining, and Elmhurst leading by 27, by 17. Hello, I can't add. And a substitution called for. Looks like there may be some blood on Kenny Payonk. Eric Dornfeld will replace him with 7:15 remaining. And a turnover as Dornfeld looked to target Morganov in the lane. 7 minutes left. Robinson pulls up, wing right, in and out. Here's Foster scooting ahead. Foster dribbles it out of bounds to Webster. Towel out on the floor. 6:49 remaining. Hollis Edwards jogs ahead. And Cody Bradfish off the window and in. Bradfish has been one of the lone bright spots for Webster today, 19 points. And timeout Elmhurst. Charles Glass was trapped in the corner. And a 30-second timeout coming for the Blue Jays.
Put Andy Leppard in. We want Leppard.
We'll keep it here during the break. And again, just let our mouths foam over some of the shooting numbers today. Unreal. How about individually right now? Nick Sanford, 19 points, 10 rebounds. Taylor Baxter with 14. Brian Ackerman, 13 off the bench for Elmhurst. Top man for Webster is Cody Bradfish, who has buried three threes. Roman Robinson with 13 as well. And again, Webster came into action today with four players averaging in double figures and one just outside. Targeting Morganov, and it's bounced out of play. Baxter in the corner. Clears it out. And Sanford is bothered in the lane. Sanford shooting free throws. No good. The second attempt, that's through. And they're calling for a towel from the Elmhurst bench yet again. They will use this opportunity to sub in Aaron Griffin with just over 6 minutes left. Mm-hmm.
Kenneth Fareed down here. He doesn't want it. Get a haircut and a razor.
Here we go, guys.
Pressure from the Blue Jays. Webster breaks, two on one, and Foster steps in front. He read it perfectly. Ackerman driving to the hole, dribbles off his knee. Danny Zahner returns for Webster. Robinson flips it in the lane for Brad Fish. He waits. Elmhurst collapses, and Morganov swats away. Deontay Foster down Main Street, poked from behind. Again today, the first ever meeting in men's basketball between Elmhurst and Webster. Elmhurst looking for victory number one of the year, and a hold is called. Playing catch, Foster attempts a three, no good. But there's Sanford again with a rebound. Score. 15 on the shot, a lot of standing around for Elmhurst. Sanford underneath. Nope. Ackerman with a rebound. Threw it away. It's Brad Fish. Behind him to Robinson on the way up is fouled. First foul on Foster. Sixth against the Blue Jays. Two free throws for Roman Robinson. Elmhurst up 16, inside of 4.5 to play.
Yep.
First free throw is in. Second free throw is in as well for Robinson, and now Webster will institute the trap. It's more of a 1-2-1-1. And it may produce a turnover, though Baxter is knocked to the floor, but he may have stepped out of bounds. Trying to avoid problems, he did indeed step out. Quick three from Brad Fish. Long, but an offensive rebound for Griffin. Falling out of bounds, who threw it away. He had time to control. Those are the kind of mistakes that have been plaguing Webster all afternoon. Baxter to Sanford, yes. Sanford the steal. Sanford coast to coast with the layup and a foul. Wow. What a day for Nick Sanford. Danny Zahner fouls out. Sanford led Elmhurst in scoring in the last three ball games, scoring 18 points in a loss to Concordia, Wisconsin, following that up with 13 at Albion and 14 in the loss to Westminster. Free throw is good. Have yourself a day, my friend. Foster today now, or Sanford, I should say, with 25 points for Elmhurst. And a floater response from Robinson. 25 points and 12 rebounds for Sanford. 12 rebounds, matches a career high, set in a win over Purdue North Central, November 27th of 2011. 25 points is a new career high. Scored 22 points in that same victory over Purdue North Central last year. Deontay Foster will shoot. 85-68 Elmhurst. Free throw is off the back iron, but in the lane anyhow, so it'll wave off.
Oh, he doesn't want it. He doesn't want
Robinson to the ball in his left hand, crossing over to the right. Smith threw it away through the arms of Lee. Chris Bunch can really hardly bear to watch on that Webster sideline. He just hung his head for a moment. 3 minutes and change to play. Ackerman looking to beat the press. Almost stepped out of bounds, but was fouled in the process by Jordan Rowland. That's the eighth on Webster. Free throw in. And good for both on Ackerman. He's putting together a strong showing today with a career high as well. Now 15 points off the bench for Elmhurst. Inside of 3 minutes, and Griffin is denied. Main Street Robinson swatted again by Morganall.
Little boy! Why are they so confused?
And Morganall shooting 1-1 for Elmhurst. Try and make it a 20-point game. No good. Ackerman fighting for the board. It's controlled by Griffin.
Acts like he's gonna do something.
2:33.
He's got Velcro shoes on. He doesn't know what he's doing.
Foster in the pocket of Rowland forces the turnover, and Sanford lost it. Baxter and Sanford to the bench for a nice round of applause.
Just give us the ball.
Eric Leonard in for Elmhurst, along with Kenny Payonk.
He doesn't want it! He doesn't want it! Oh, you're running ISO. You're gonna do something!
Shot clock winding down. Robinson left it short, but an offensive rebound for Smith.
With your triple double. Why you look like a bum? No, you don't want it.
Smith, short of the free throw line.
got your money back in that shooting sleeve, Rondo. That's that Walmart discount bin. I see you.
87-68 with less than 2 minutes left. Elmhurst spreading the floor. Foster retreating. Some fresh bodies at the scorer's table here. Three-pointer denied. Leonard's three was blocked by Robinson, who's off of the races, and Foster with a piece to knock it away as well. Here comes Leonard, 2-on-1, and Leonard will ease up as we close in on 1 minute to play. Timeout Elmhurst for substitutions. Peyton Wyatt, Andy Lepard in for the Blue Jays. Also in, Tyler Thurston. Webster clearing the bench as well. Eric Crittenden off the bench for Elmhurst. Jared Husky for Webster. 1:03 to play. And it'll be Thurston inbounding towards Peyton Wyatt. The only thing left to decide here is the final margin, but Elmhurst will pick up win number one of the year this afternoon at home over Webster. A very strong performance, putting 87 points on the board right now. Crittenden from the baseline fires one long and into the bench. And I know you're wondering, the 87 points for Elmhurst, easily the highest this year. Previous high total was 71 at a one-point loss to the University of Dubuque. Darrell Lee into the lane, out for a three-point attempt. Taylor Walton's try is long. Rebound in the vicinity of Jordan Rowland, and the shot clock is off. And a floater scores from Husky. High water mark for Elmhurst last year was 84 in a win over Carthage on February 14th. Trying to go back and look at the last time that Elmhurst was able to put up 87 points. As the final 3 seconds tick away, and your final score, Elmhurst 87, Webster 70, a 17-point win. 85 points in a season-ending win over Milliken in the 2010-2011 season. Continue to dig back through the archives of Elmhurst College men's basketball. 94 points in a win over Redlands, 91 over Fontbonne, 95 in a loss to Aurora. Those were all in the 2009-2010 campaign, during which Elmhurst finished 6-19. So the last time they had scored more than 87 points came on December 19th of 2009. In a 12-point loss to Aurora, 107-95. But the Blue Jays with 87 points today and an impressive, impressive showing on the way to win number one of the season. 25 points and 12 rebounds from Nick Sanford. Brian Ackerman, 15 off the bench. Taylor Baxter, 14 as well, as Elmhurst flexes its muscles and puts away 5 games of frustration on one afternoon. The Blue Jays are back in action this week. They'll take on Lawrence. That'll come your way on Wednesday at 7 o'clock. I believe that's an audio-only broadcast here on Blue Jay TV. But as always, visit the Elmhurst College website, elmhurstbluejays.com, for further details. We'll have them all for you as well. First win of the season for Elmhurst. For our entire crew here on Blue Jay TV, I'm Tim Calderwood. Thanks for watching.